Hi everyone, I'm Tom and today I'm going to be playing Weather Machine. This is the latest game from Vital Lacerda, who you might recognise from such games as Kanban, Escape Plan, On Mars, Lisboa, The Gallerist, Vinos, CO2 Second Chance, all of which you can see playthroughs for on this channel, plug, but the latest one is here on Kickstarter right now. From Eagle Griffin Games, art again by the masterful Ian O'Toole. And I'm going to be playing a two-player game today against Little Glass Marty to see who is the best at weather. Professor Lativ over here, and over here, this kind of chitty-chitty bang-bang character, has decided to eradicate natural disasters. He's made a weather machine. He's been tweaking the weather around the world. You know, making it windy by wind farms. Clear skies for solar farms. Nice temperature for your holidays, but we have realised that, or maybe re-realised, that for every action, there is an opposite reaction, and somewhere else in the world, bad things happen. Bad weather is happening. Natural disasters are kind of increasing as we are trying to fix them. And so Professor Lativ has come up with a brand new prototype for the ultimate in weather machine. The government has stepped in because, well, we've kind of made the world go wrong, or wronger. They recognize that we are the only people that can fix this, so they have decided to lend their assistance and their funding to try and help us achieve our aims. We are the assistants of Professor Lativ, and we are going to be gathering supplies, chemicals, machine parts, workshops, building robots to help us. We are going to be getting subsidies from the government to help us run the weather machine. We are going to be running experiments on various types of weather and building prototypes to help fix the weather that we've made worse around the world. Before we go any further, I would recommend you turn on the Klingon subtitles. If I've made any mistakes, they'll be corrected there. Thanks, Steve. And I will tell you now, as further warning, Vital Lacerda tends to make big, crunchy, heavier games. Mistakes may well happen. Look, a robot's already fallen over. And also, if you would like to help me keep making playthroughs, it is patreon.com/slickerdrips. That is the place that would be amazing for you to visit and join up. Keep me doing all of this. And I've mentioned it already, but this is on Kickstarter right now. The campaign page is linked in the description, and the corner of the screen may well have already been in the corner of the screen. I've gone on with the description of the game a bit longer than I normally would. But you can see all of the fun stuff there. This is a prototype, but I think it's kind of like it's like a pre-production copy, this. I think this will be very representative of what the final game would look like. So in setup, we have Professor Lativ's assistant here. His robot assistant is on a certain type of weather in the weather machine. In the research department, that's determined by this tile here. We shuffle them all up. They're in various categories. Reveal three here. That's the next one to come out. That's the one to come out after that. So these aren't, you know, up for experiment yet, but we can see what's going to be on the schedule in the future. That determines where the assistant is. Professor Lativ and the players always start here. We did random turn order. I am first for now. We start off with the same number of vouchers. These are action points, essentially. You'll see how we do all of that when we get started. And we have a random machine part. It has to be a different color, and a random warehouse for us to keep things in. Before the game starts, we get a post-setup supply round. Supply is an action that you can take. You can come to the supply section and it will be much the same as what we're about to do now, but everyone gets a chance to do it so they can kind of go their own way. So what can you do in the supply section? Everything here is going to cost you supply vouchers. See, next to every icon here, there is either a number of arrows, that's how many vouchers it costs you, or a question mark means the robot section will tell you how much that costs. So I can adjust turn order. For one supply voucher, and we all start the game with four, I could adjust the turn order. I could put myself anywhere in the turn order. I'm quite happy with being first, though. I could get myself robots. Robots are useful for all of the other sections of the game. You send robots to perform experiments and make the experiments happen, and you'll get them back afterwards. You send them to take these subsidy tiles, extra actions, and you send them to research in R&D. They don't come back from there, though. At the beginning of the game, we have access to these two sections of robots. We can ignore these lower down ones. The ones in the left column cost one voucher. The ones on the right cost two vouchers. When you get one of these robots, it will give you a reward. These five robots here all give you vouchers of some kind. This one gives you machine parts back. Science vouchers are special. Sometimes you will be asked to spend science vouchers, and then they have to be science, but science is also a wildcard voucher. It can be used as anything. So I could buy myself some robots. I could buy myself more space in my workshop. On our player boards, we have space for a chemical of any colour, a machine part of any colour, and a robot. These spaces are specific to those things. Workshop spaces can house a machine part or a robot, one or the other. And as we collect more warehouses, they have to match up like this colour-wise. I have now given myself another storage space for the red chemical. I realise they all have names, they're complicated, I can't remember them. So that's why you would want more workshops, and finally you can buy chemicals here. At the start of the game, all chemicals are one supply point each. As they get more scarce as the game goes on, they will start costing two or even three. Another action you can do here is sell back your chemicals. So you could do a little bit of wheeling and dealing here. Buy them cheap, sell them high, and get yourself more supply vouchers to spend on other things. Now I'm going to buy a white chemical. You'll see why soon enough. So that cost me one supply voucher, and I want robots. We'll get into these more later, but I have goals that they're all from a particular type. I might not get all of these. I have to pay to get them on my player board. But if I do, a lot want me to have a lot of robots. And it's useful to have a lot as well. Now, if I want to buy three robots, I have three supply vouchers left. I've only got space for two. So I'm going to have to buy a warehouse. So I'm going to have to spend a supply voucher to buy a warehouse. I could buy any of these five. So the four in the display and the one on the top of the face-up stack. So you have to match up colours. So I could either get one with a red or a blue on it, but you can also build outwards. You don't have to match them up. You can build outwards like this, and you will need to when you build a prototype. A prototype is going to need a certain combination of gears. You may need more or less as the game goes on, and they all need to be in the same row. A certain set of colours in the same row. So yeah, we might need them out like that. For the start though, I think, what am I feeling like? I think blue would be good to have. So I'm going to get a space for a blue there. I'm going to get a robot. That costs me a supply voucher, gets me a government voucher, can go in the robot-y space. And I will spend a supply voucher to get a robot that gives me an R&D voucher. Do I want to spend a science to get another robot? I would like to, you know, keep things going and not have to come here so quick. Yeah, let's do one more. Robots, robots, robots. So that gets me a lab voucher. And I'm full up, and I have got one more science voucher. I could buy something else, but no, I'm going to hang on to that because that could be used as something else. That is my post-setup supply phase. Oh, we need to fill up the display when someone takes a workshop. So now Marty could take first player for the first round of the game, but I don't think he's going to do that just yet. We'll see that when we take our turns. Marty's going to go for a blue chemical. Can go there, because anything can go there. He needs at least a couple of robots for his purposes. He's going to go for, yeah, a lab voucher and a government voucher. Oh, and he's going to buy two workshops. He needs workshop space as well, I think. Let's see, he's going to have space for a green chemical, and then he'll build out with one. So you're getting some different colours. Not a lot of different has come out, has it? Oh, blue and white. There we go. Yes, okay. I'm happy with that. So now we have done the post-setup supply round. That's technically just setup you've seen and you haven't actually seen a turn yet, but when we come here later to do supply, there's a little thing that happens first, but then that is the supply action you have seen there. So now we can go into the normal round sequence, which is here, A, B, C. A is player actions. We do them in this order. On your turn, and you can see on your player board, first of all, you can use a subsidy tile if you've got one. I haven't. And you can use an investment tile if you've got one. It's one or the other. See, at the start of the game, you won't have these things. Then move your assistant marker somewhere on the board. Has to go to a different place. In a two-player game, the rightmost action spot on the two, three, and four locations is blocked off. And in the first round of the game, you can't choose the leftmost space. So I'm going to have to pick a department. I'm going to tell you right now, it's government. I love the government section. The difference in the action slots and all of this symbolism over here. So the leftmost action here, you see it's got an and. That means you can do either of the two actions of the location or both if you want to and can. This means pick one of them. For placing my assistant here, I get a type of voucher. So I am going to get a lab voucher. So move my marker up there. I've got three of those now. This down here means for everyone to your left, get an extra lab voucher. If Professor Lativ is to your left, get a science voucher. In a two-player game, because there's not as many of us about, Professor Lativ counts as another player for getting you that voucher and getting you the science voucher. At the moment, though, I'm just there on my own. This is where the game's drawn some comparisons to Kanban, because in Kanban, there are different sections where you can do various actions in those sections, and your main action in a turn is putting your worker somewhere over here, and we have a person that is moving from section to section, like Sandra in Kanban. But it's quite different, because Professor Lativ does not move unless we go to his location. He's also not judging us. Well, maybe he is, but he isn't. He's not letting us know about it if he is. Either way, I have done section 2. Move my scientist. Section 3 is perform actions. It's here because you will need to spend vouchers to do actions. I have two options here. I can sell a part. This is basically putting a bot out into the government section and spending a gear of the corresponding color to take one of these subsidy tiles next to my board, and then I can use it in phase one of my turn in the future. It's just a one-off, but I do have a potential goal for me is to have the most or tie for the most subsidy tiles. So something I could think about. You will also move up the funding track for government, and you will get a research token. Research tokens are so key to this. So the core thing, Paul Grogan, actually, who's done a playthrough himself, you can watch on the Gaming Rules channel. Paul Grogan put it really well about Weather Machine, that it's all about working backwards. What do you need to do in this game? Fix the weather. What do you need to do to fix the weather? You need to build a prototype. So you need certain configurations of gears or have sent bots over here and space in your workshop. But to be able to take this action, you have to have published research. How do you publish research? You have to have filled a row with the same type of weather in different research actions. How do you get those research tokens? You have to have done certain actions in government and R&D and been part of a successful experiment in the lab. How do you do those? Well, we'll get into that. I'll stop working backwards now. Let's just do my action. I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to take the other action, the more expensive action. This is two government vouchers. This is secure a subsidy. It costs me my two government vouchers. I pick any of the subsidy tokens here. I gain the vouchers that are at the top of the column and the left of the row for the thing that I pick. I'm not going to pick this one, by the way. This is just an example. And then I take the action on the subsidy tile and flip it over. Anyone doing this action in the future can't choose that one anymore. You have to choose a blue tile. But someone choosing this action to take the tile for themselves could choose that, and then it goes blue again and available. So what am I going to do? Well, the rulebook even advises you, and it's a fantastic idea, to take extra actions, bonus actions. Anything here with this symbol on it, they're for different sections, but basically for each of these left actions for the various departments, there are two subsidy tiles that basically take that action for free. So I could take that leftmost action for free by doing this as my secure a subsidy action. You see, it's got the same symbol here, the blue cog and then the government symbol next to it. And you know what? I'm going to do that. I had another idea in mind, but this is even better. Right, I'm going to... So there's that one there that I could take. It would get me an R&D voucher and a science. Or this one here would get me a science and an R&D... Okay, they're the exact same. This is randomly put out. Let's do this one. So I get a science, an R&D, and then I flip, and I get to take this action, but the bonus as well, it's extra actions, but you don't have to pay the cost of the action. You have to pay a machine part to take this sell a part action, but I don't need to do that. So let's go through the steps. I don't need to spend vouchers because I'm getting to do this for free. I move up the funding track. Now, the funding tracks have slightly different ways of earning you money, but basically, we are going to, in the future, have investment tiles. We can use those investment tiles to get us end game goals. We can keep using future investment tiles to get more goals in there, 5 points for every goal you successfully do at the end of the game. Or, if you've already put a goal out, you can flip it and score the funding for that particular funding track. So this is blue, it would be the government track. Government gets you the bonus underneath your marker and everything to the left of it. So early on, that's just get any one voucher. But if you're all the way up here, it would be get a free robot and move up any funding track and get any chemical and get any voucher. So it can be very lucrative if you focus your efforts on one track. So then I need to place a robot out into one of these sections here. Normally, that might be dictated by the machine part you've got available to pay, but the machine part is being provided by this subsidy tile. They are absolutely fantastic. I am coming over here. Maybe keep my options open in future because there's two white and one blue. I'll take one of the whites. So the options, yeah, they're a bit available. And I want this. This is similar to what I have just done here. It is take the research action over in R&D without paying the chemical. So that goes there. I can't do it now. It's the first thing you do on your turn, but I can do it next time. Oh, it's going to be great. So then, yes, paid the machine part. The machine part comes from the supply because I am getting it given to me for free by the government subsidy. This thematically is giving the government the parts they need to help in their own government weather machine. And the government will contribute to the easing of the bad weather if a column is full of machine parts. Finally, I get the research token for fog. So when you get a research token, it needs to come down to your desk area here. I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but there are some Easter eggs hidden in the desks that do not give you bonuses. See if you can see what they are. So things you got from the government go in this column, things you got from the lab in this column, R&D in this column. Your restriction for roses, it must be the same kind of weather. I think I am going to pop this down. And you're also thinking about, so I could get a bonus right now, but you're thinking about when you publish a paper, which we'll see later on, you can get this bonus over here. I think I would love moving up funding tracks, free robot. And this also has the benefit of giving me two supply vouchers when I need to go back to the supply department. So, well, the turns aren't all like that, but yes, you can end up comboing. The voucher, by the way, it goes up here, and then you must put it out at the end of your turn. But it was the end of my turn. Just so we're clear on that. You can also get award tokens later on. They don't have to go out at the end of your turn. You just can put them out at any time during your turn. So we finally finished my turn. I will stop hogging the game and Marty will have a choice. So since we can't go in the leftmost spaces, Marty cannot choose government. He can't choose supply because he's there. So would he like lab or R&D? He's going to go lab. So for coming here, he gets an R&D voucher. He chooses, does he want to publish a paper? Well, no one's doing that early on. You need a full row of research tokens with an asterisk on that. As these padlocks get removed, you can do it with just two, but that happens later. For now, we're doing the leftmost action. We are doing work on an experiment. So this costs one lab voucher. It moves Marty up the lab funding track. How does the lab funding track work? It's the same thing for activating it. You know, you have to have used an investment tile to get a lab goal out onto your board, and then later on use another investment tile to flip that lab goal. You'll still get the points at the end of the game, but then you activate its funding. How does this work? Well, first of all, you get the number of science vouchers equal to where you are and to the left. So at the moment he would get none, but later on that would give him one, that would give him two, you see the science voucher symbols, or up to three. But then you get to get the funding of one of the other funding tracks as if your marker was this many spaces further forward than it actually is. So the lab funding track could potentially be the most lucrative. It gets you the fewest points at the end of the game. So you get 7 points for moving high up the other tracks. But the bonuses, oh, they can be wild. Part two of the work on an experiment action. This is much simpler action. You need to put a bot on one of the spaces that are available, and you need to pay the corresponding chemical. So Marty is going to pop his bot up here, and he needs to pay the blue chemical for that. It goes back to the supply. He could place it in a space with a robot. In a two-player game, these spaces are all filled with robots for now, and more robots are added as Professor Latif moves. Marty is hoping to force an experiment over here. He wants to conduct an experiment. You need the column full of robots there. We'll talk about that in a minute. But yeah, he's hoping to do that himself. And maybe I'm going to realize, well, I might get cut out of this. So he's moved his assistant. He's had actions. There are all of these actions you can see have got the one X next to them, one times. You can only do any of these actions once per turn. So if I had, you know, this subsidy tile down here that let me take this action at the start of my turn, I couldn't then move my assistant here and then choose to pay to take that action. I've already done it once that turn. So we've both had our actions. That is A, done. B, does the weather machine run? For the experiment to run, the bot is on wind here. There has to be a wind experiment up there to be performed. There is not. So we already know the experiment isn't running. But the second condition is the column, the active branch, needs to be full of bots. So on both counts, the experiment does not run. If it does not run, any players with bots here can choose to bring them back. There is, you know, sometimes risk involved because you've got to hope that other players will contribute to the experiments, but they probably want the rewards as well. But yeah, putting your bot out in an experiment that is not going to happen for ages is very risky. It's wasteful, you know, your bot's there doing nothing for ages. And also, Professor Latif bots return. Whether the experiment runs or not, we discard the rightmost experiment tile matching that type. There wasn't one. The assistant moves to the right. So this is where our strategies are going to come into this. Marty's strategy is to force this experiment to run by himself. It doesn't matter to him whether I'm involved or not. He is going to force that to trigger next round. My plan, which has been delayed a little bit because I've got this investment marker, is to go all in on fog. You know, I've got this research token. I'm going to use this bonus in a minute to get that research token. And then the round after next, as long as I can put a bot on there, I will force that experiment to run and I will get that fog token and I can quickly start to do, you know, publishing and breakthroughs. That's my big plan. And that's also why I chose a white chemical, because white chemical is how I get a bot in there. C is end of round. If the marker's got adjusted by someone taking a supply action, we resolve the turn order again. If Professor Latif is here, everyone gets income. What is your income? It's everything you've put a bot out from your first two sections here. You get those vouchers and or machine parts. At the moment, he hasn't moved yet. He doesn't move until someone goes to supply. So we go back to a new round and phase A. I need to choose somewhere to go. But first of all, I can use my subsidy marker. So this is take the research action for no vouchers and without having to pay the chemical. So I flip that over. That is used for the game now. What are the steps? I move up the funding track. This is the last one I need to explain to you. This funding track works by you choosing. You gain the benefit of the furthest one that you are above or to the left of you, or you can choose a worse one. This is because maybe you're really high up here later and, oh, you'll get 7 points for doing this, but maybe you would rather have 5 points in a machine part or two machine parts, depending on what you need to do. At the moment, if I got this income, I would get myself a machine part. Then, place a bot on a space paying the relevant chemical. I am placing my robot on this space. Now, there is an extra cost of coming to this section. Any of these at the bottom, they either want you to pay an extra chemical of any type or an extra machine part of any type. This is because their bonus is better. They get you a free robot. So I need to pay. So blue is coming from the tile itself, the subsidy tile tells me I can do the action without having to pay the chemical. So this comes from the supply and stays on that action, as does my robot for the rest of the game. And I need to pay a machine part. Well, here is my starting machine part. It is paid. I now get a free robot. That's section four, take the benefit of the space. I've saved, you know, my slightly more expensive robots for this time. So what I like, an extra science voucher, a supply voucher or a machine part. I have just spent my machine part, haven't I? Let's take a science. Science good for everything. So, yeah, I get a new robot now. Can't go there. Have I done all the steps? No, I get the research token. I'm going to keep putting it in the same row because I'm so close to filling this row up and then being able to go and publish a paper. So that is step one of my turn. Now I need to choose somewhere to go. Now, it was always going to be the lab. I can't go here again. I don't think I want to resupply just yet. Yeah, it's going to be the lab, which is a bit of a waste. I've already got three R&D vouchers. It's just wasted. If you can't earn it, tough luck. I don't get anything extra because I am not to the left of Marty. I'm to the right. I'm going in the better action slot. But unfortunately, you can't do this until you have filled up the row. All the places have been unlocked and you can site, but that's not happening yet. So I am kind of wasting this a little bit. I only get to do one action, which is the action Marty just took. Now, I could have delayed and done something else because my experiment isn't happening until next round. I don't need to come here until next round. But what's kind of set me off now is Marty is making a different experiment happen. And I kind of want to be in on this. The downside is I took the white chemical here and what I need is the salmon or the red. You can, if you want to take this space, you can move Professor Latif's bot to another space, or you can just move him off. But there is kind of, this is built into the game. If you don't have the voucher you need, these executive actions, Peter loves his executive actions. You can spend any three vouchers to get yourself a science voucher, which can be used as any voucher. So, you're never completely stuck. If you need a different colour of machine part, you can spend any two vouchers to swap your machine part. If you need a different chemical, you can spend any two vouchers to swap around a chemical. Do you see where I'm going with this? So I think I'm going to spend, definitely not supply. The lab's going to cost me one, but I probably want to come back and publish a paper soon. I'm going to spend two R&D vouchers. Breaks my heart, because you can only do this when you need to pay for something but can't. So I'm doing the action. I spent the lab voucher to come here. I move up the funding track. I don't have the right chemical, so I paid the two vouchers to swap my chemical for, let's just say, the salmon one. And then I pay it back to the supply, and my bot goes out there. So the experiment will run, but now I can have... I can get a cut. That's it for me. The lab is the only place where you do not gain the research tokens from taking one of the actions. You do indirectly, but you get the research tokens from having taken part in an experiment. Marty, we're kind of swapping here. Marty's coming over to the government section, but he's going to get to do both actions. So for coming here, he gets a lab voucher. Then what is he going to choose to do? He wants a free action. He could... What he was thinking about doing before was putting another bot in here. He'll get more points for doing that. But he could be a bit tactical and sneaky about this. So first of all, he's going to do the get a subsidy. Two government vouchers. He's going to take put another bot in the lab. Yeah, he'll just do that. So doesn't have to pay the chemical for it. He's going to come into the sun column. Now, this experiment is already happening, but there is a benefit for Marty doing this. We'll see when the experiment runs. And he also gets a science and a lab voucher for doing that. He's got no government vouchers to take the other action, but that's okay because he's got a science to spend. Oh, I've done it the wrong way around. No, this is the one he wants to take as the subsidy action. It's the same action. He's going to come over now. Oh, but now he's got no bot. Oh, no. Okay, Marty isn't quite as stylish as all of that. What he was going to do was take the other one away because he knows I need to come over here now to get a bot there next time to do what I want because I don't have any chemicals. So I need to get a free chemical. So take that back. He's not going to go in there because he wants to do this action twice. So first of all, for the subsidy, he will gain a supply and a science and get himself a free robot. So supply, science, and then a robot. You might as well go for the more expensive one. These come unlocked, by the way, when you have six robots unlocked. So all of these unlocked. Or you've got five or more research tokens, or just tokens here, because you could have research or award or citation tokens there. As soon as you've got five wooden things here, you can start coming from here. If you've got nine robots, so all these others, or eight wooden things here, you can start taking from this section. These benefits are all moving up a funding track. These benefits, you know, a free left lab action up any track or any chemical. I mean, there are fireworks going off right now. It is... Bonfire night, but it is also like 11 a.m. on bonfire night. I don't think you're getting the full effect of them. So he's done that side. This side, he'll have to spend a science to be allowed to do. And he moves up the funding track. Then he can put his bot out. It needs to be somewhere where he can spend a blue. So in one of these columns, I think it's better to be involved in the experiments. He's going to come over here. He needs to spend a blue machine part to take this freebie that he was going to do earlier, but I worked it out wrong. And then he gets a wind, which he will use. Yeah, I think he's going to go in the same as me. He wants some supply points because the cupboards are bare for Marty as well. It would have been nice for Marty to get one of these, so he's getting sun as well. But we'll see, we'll see. Okay, so we've had our actions. Does the weather machine run? Yes, because there is a sun experiment in the display. The column is full of bots. The experiment happens. So what happens now? In turn order. So starting with me, take your bots back. So I've got one bot there. Pay the science cost that's on the experiment tile. I am happy to pay that. You don't have to pay it. If you don't, though, you don't get any of the rewards. Well, you still get the research token, but there's lucrative things here you want. So I get my bot back, I've paid my one science, and I now get 5 points for every bot I had there. That's why Marty wanted to try and get another one out there. And also get two machine parts, which I'm tempted by, or an investment marker. Ooh, the investment marker could help me get a chemical. No, I'll go for machine parts. We're looking at fog. The cogs there are white. I'm going to take two white machine parts. And you're allowed to move stuff around in your warehouse how you like. So I'm going to do that. That's me. Morty gets a bot back. He will spend his last remaining science to get 5 points himself, and he can choose two machine parts or an investment tile. Morty's going to go machine parts as well. He's going to go blue and red. We've done those steps. We each get a research token. Now, if only one of us had gone here, this is why I was so desperate as well. If only Morty had done this experiment, a bot is present, so Professor Lativ would have taken the other research token away. So, yeah, I wanted to be involved in this. Morty's going to pop his out here and get even more supply. 5 supply vouchers now. Like, I want to try and go up funding. I'm going to pop mine there because of the reward here. Now, we've been experimenting on the weather. As we said at the start, that makes the weather worse. I'm grabbing the wrong thing. Sun. It's getting very, very hot in a certain area of the world because of what we're doing. It now takes fewer attempts to fix that weather in future, but takes an extra machine part now. And there is a science cost to making a breakthrough over there. So the weather's worse. We discard the rightmost relevant experiment tile, slide them along, and you can see what's coming out. Lativ's bots also come off. The experiment happened, and he moves along. So let's talk about the triggers for the end of the game. The end of the game is triggered if somebody earns the Nobel Prize. They get this for their third award token, which you get from doing breakthroughs. When the last experiment is placed in the display. So basically there will be no tiles on these two spaces. They'll all be in the display. If the government machine is full of bots, or R&D is full of bots. I feel like those are less likely in a two-player game. We finish the round and play one more round, and in that final round, every eligible experiment runs. So there are no research tokens left for Sun. You'll get a science voucher instead if you take part in future experiments. So we are done. C, nothing changes. Back to A. So I want to be involved in another experiment. I do not have chemicals, though. I do not have time to spend an entire round going and getting chemicals. So I'm going to have to take the suboptimal government space because I only get to do either or. But Marty is stood next to me, so I get a lab and another lab. So I've got 4 of those vouchers now. And I have to choose one of them to do. Well, if I want to be part of the experiment this round, I need to do the subsidy action. So 2... Oh, no. 2 government vouchers. It's okay. It's not too bad. Means I need to spend my 2 science vouchers. I don't want that. But at least I have to pick this one. It's the only one left. So I will earn another research voucher, another lab voucher, and a science voucher. Because I'm going to need a science voucher to pay for the fog experiment and get the rewards. You know, it's not the end of the world. You still get the research token, which is the big deal. But there we go. Flip that over and I get to take the put a bot out action for free. So I move up the funding track, put a robot out. I want it to go there and no reward yet. Now, Marty has taken this for himself. So I think, yeah, what it's another. Now, the rubric also does say, try to focus on 2 types of weather early on. So this is another type Marty's getting himself involved in. But he's going to do it. Yeah, he's going to knock the facility bot out of there. Downside is, though, he does not have a science. He could maybe earn one on his turn, though. Isn't that his turn yet? Oh, yeah, that would be good. Yes, he's going to do that. So he's got no more bots left. He moves up the funding track as well. Then, doesn't have to spend the chemical because he got it for free like I did. Then he is, for his action, coming over here to the supply action. So, gets any voucher, including science. He'll choose science. If Professor Lativ is there, he gets a science. And for everyone to your left, you need to pay any voucher. There's nobody there. He's there. After you've earned all of your vouchers and stuff, Professor Lativ moves on. In a two-player game, when he enters government or R&D, he removes a research token based on where his assistant is. So unfortunately for Marty, he's not going to be able to get the fog research token from there. He will have to use an award or site if he wants to do fog in future. But maybe he won't. So he's got pretty full supply points here. He wants chemicals. They're cheap. He will get a green because he's got a specific space for it. Let's see. Snow next. Are we gonna be in that? You know, we need to both be on there or someone needs to have 2 next round. I don't think that's happening. So what would the experiment be after that? Rain? Maybe a bit more likely. They're both quite lucrative, but we've got to kind of trust that the other one's going to do it or that we've got enough actions to be able to do the whole thing ourselves. If they don't happen, they disappear as well. So actually, if Yeah, that's going to happen and bring wind in. And then ice isn't going to happen and bring the other rain in. And we don't know what's going to happen after that. Oh, also, when Professor Lateef moves, he puts a bot out where his assistant is. If there's no space, we go along. They only go on the bottom row. There's already one there. He puts one in fog. So maybe fog's the thing to be thinking about, which would need a blue chemical. So another supply voucher to get a blue chemical. He's going to buy another workshop. And a white chemical. I think he needs bots. He's going to pay, and that'll give him an R&D point. And then, yeah, he'll pay two science as vouchers to get this bot out, which gives him a science back. So he's still got his science to pay. And I think he's made the most out of a supply action. Okay, fill the workshops back up. We've both had our turns. Does an experiment happen? Yes. So does an experiment happen? Yes. There is fog, and there we are. So, turn order still. He could have made himself first. I don't know that he cares too much, though, to be honest. By me going first, I'm going to clear out of there and he can go back to government if he wants. He's got no vouchers, though. Yeah, Marty's going to be limited by the vouchers he hasn't got. We'll see what happens. So, I go first. Bring back... And the turn order wouldn't change just yet anyway. It'd change in C. But hey, stop introducing new elements. Just explain what you're talking about. I need to... play a science, get 2 points. We're both going to get 2 points. I'm going to move us both up now. And do I want to put a bot? We could both make snow happen. This is just doing all the weather types. So I could either get an investment marker or I could put a bot out. So I could come back here next time. I don't have a resource though. So no, I couldn't come back. It's a bit of a gamble. Do I come out here and hope that Marty chooses this as well? But he could leave me high and dry, which knowing Marty, he'd do. Yeah, I'm going to go for the investment marker. Now, Marty's got chemicals. He's got a green chemical, in fact, so he could force it to happen himself. Oh no, all of this just... Oh no, this mental loop the loop. Yeah, Marty, this is another type of weather he's getting into. We'll see if it works. Let go. He's going to need to find science from somewhere. He's going to pay. I've given him his 2 points already. He's going to come out in here because he's got a green that he could pay for. And yeah, so he's taking that as his bonus. We both get the fog. So I am definitely going to place it in there so I can now publish. Marty will place it in here so he can get some vouchers back. Then the weather gets worse. And if the weather gets worse, that gets discarded. Marty should have had his bot. Oh, no. Yeah, Marty should have had his bot back. The assistant moves on, experiments slide along, and after that, the rain. It's going to be wind again. Okay, so, turn order's the same, Lateef isn't here yet, and so new round. I need to choose somewhere to be. I am worried about the lack of chemicals. Marty has successfully locked me out of that. I don't have any chemicals. I've got to come down here then, haven't I? I could come here and do a breakthrough. The downside of that is... Oh, I have an investment... Ooh, this changes things. I can get a chemical with my investment marker. Yes. So first of all, spend my investment marker. It goes away. Then I need to choose a goal that I'm going to go for. Most subsidy tiles, not that great. By the way, you can... So these all come from a set. See, mine have all got the plus on, Marty's have all got the triangle. You can play a more advanced variant where you draft these at the start. You need 3 of each colour, but... You can mix and match. So have the most or equal subsidy tiles, the joint or most empty assembly spaces, the most or joint most published papers. 5 different government research tokens. Oh, actually, if I get awards and citations, they count as different as well. 3 complete rows, 5 bots in R&D. The most or joint most on the R&D funding track. 6 tokens in my lab column. Or 5 bots in government branches. What seems most likely? I'm going to say 3 completed rows. So I can put it here or here. I can get myself a machine part or a voucher stroke cylinder. So I want the cylinder. Yeah, I can get involved in this. Yes, this is going to be great. I have the vouchers to do it as well. So I'll get myself a green. Boom. For my turn, come over here. Get me an R&D, and I can do both things. So first of all, the one we know and love. Spend a lab voucher, move up the funding track, place a bot out, paying the cylinder. Why am I getting all hooked into all of these different experiments now? I don't want Marty to have all of the glory. Oh, but I haven't got a science. I have got 3 things I could spend for a science, though. Yes. So done. Next up, two vouchers to publish a paper. So choose a completed row in your office. Yes, slide your breakthrough marker along. Get the reward, which is a robot for me. I only have four things here, unfortunately, so it's going to have to come from up here. I don't want another machine part. A supply voucher is always welcome. So I'll pop that there. Oh no, I'm not going to have space for all of my robots, and you're not allowed to throw things away. Oh, I wish I'd never taken these these machine parts. But I'm kind of interrupting what I wanted to do to get involved in this experiment. But I want to publish papers. I want to publish papers. So yeah, that's just going to have to be a reality of the robot, unfortunately. So yes, don't need to cite. I know this is in the wrong space. Marty should never have had those supply tokens. Oh no. Did he already use them? Well, there's no going back if he did. Did he just gain them? I think he only just got them, right? He'll put this up here and get funding instead. So I earn points now based on the values of what's in that row. Every award token is worth 4 points. Every research token is worth 2 points. Every citation token is worth no points. So 2, 4, 6 points for me. Then get an investment token. Then unlock the citation. So that is Fog. Marty can now cite Fog. So if he gets another Fog token, which is going to have to come from over here, if he gets that, he can then come and publish, only having two. He puts a citation in there, which isn't worth any points, but yeah, it means that he can do this action a bit easier now. I can, at the point of this being unlocked, pay a science to get 3 points. I don't have any science. I can use three of something else, but I'm kind of already going to do that to get another investment marker here, I think. So there we go, I've done two things here, haven't I? Marty, government is always really tempting. He could come over here and get a bot out in Fog. He has got a white to get that token and get moving on that. Because, like, look at his vouchers is what I'm kind of worried about for him. Coming to government is the ideal thing to do, but it costs two things. So he can't afford to do that, basically. He would need six vouchers to substitute. So he can't come over here, which is the best thing to do. Oh, he'd get a science first and another lab, so he could do it. He would get a government for coming here, though. And then maybe next turn he comes and does that, but I'll probably do it. He's going to come here. He gets himself a government voucher. He's going to contribute, put his butt out here. He can get any voucher for himself. He'll get a science then for when the experiment happens. And yep. Had the reward. Oh, move up the funding track. Don't forget that. And get the Fog. Now, if somebody comes here in the future, completes the branch, you get an investment tile. And if it hasn't happened already, unlock the citation. So that's Marty. Does an experiment happen? Yes, again. It's me. Now, I can't pay a science. I'm not coming to research again, so I'll do 1, 2. I do want to go there. I'm not going to be able to. I'm going to have to supply, probably. 3. So I can pay a science. It'll get me another investment. I didn't use my investment marker, did I, on my turn? I think I earned it on my turn. Yeah, I earned it on my turn. Yeah, I haven't got space for two more machine parts. I'm already losing this robot. So I can put it back in any empty space. Government. That's unfortunate. I want the investment marker. I can only use one per turn, so I need to keep up on that. Yep. 5 points I don't think I've had. Marty, he has got a science now. He can have his 5 points, and he wants... Ooh. Investment marker. Definitely investment marker. So, yes, he gets his thing back. Bot, you go there. You move on. You get discarded. The weather gets worse. Have to remember that. Weather gets worse. So many experiments being done in this game. Then, done all of the things. Professor Latif still hasn't moved, although I think I'm going to change that. Turn order hasn't changed. Okay, so my turn. Oh, we haven't had our research tokens. Let's just do supply. Marty, he would like to just have vouchers. He wants funding. There we go. First of all, investment. So I could flip this over and have my funding. One science. And get another track as if I'm two spaces further along. Any voucher and any chemical there, or a machine part and 3 points there. Or I could just put something new out and fund later when I'm a bit further along, maybe? Yeah, let's earn something. I am going to have the most published papers. If I want three complete rows, I can do the most published papers. I'm going to take any question mark and it's going to be a science. So that's an investment marker spent. I'm going to come down to, I'm so tempted to do government. Because I love it, but I'm coming down to supply. Take anything, I'll take another science. So I've got 5 vouchers to do this. What am I going to do? Now, fog is coming up. Well, that's in the wrong space. I don't have 2 supply vouchers. I did the exact same as Marty. I need more warehouse space. So that's 1. I want a machine port. 1, 2. That gives me a robot, and then I'm not going to have space. We'll get another warehouse space then. Let's link it up so I can have a green port. That seems okay. Yeah. So another bot, and I want a green machine port, because then I could do the breakthrough here, and I'll show you a breakthrough 7 hours into the video. So is that all I'm doing? My vouchers. I don't want to spend the last one. No. Leave that there. I've got another investment market. We can get vouchers back. We can get income and stuff. It's all going to be fantastic. Okay, Marty could now get published, but he's only got 1 voucher. First of all, he's going to go to the professor. That's a good way of getting vouchers. First of all, gets a research voucher, gets... Oh, 2 research vouchers, because the... Maybe I should have done this. 2 research vouchers, because it's 2 players and he counts as another player, and a science, because it's the professor. He moves along to the leftmost space that's available. He puts a bot out. Can't. There we go. So Marty gets to choose one of the things. Oh, he could have done investment first as well. Yeah, investments. Backtracking. Marty's going to have 5 different things in his lab column. And he's going to get a voucher. Let's just say science. You might as well just always say science if you've got space. He's coming here. He's spending 2 government vouchers to do a subsidy. And it's going to be this one for a free sell apart voucher. Yes. So he's going to get himself an R&D and a science. R&D and a science. Flip that over and then do this part for free. Gets up the funding track, then gets... Has to lose a bot. But he wants to be in different branches. And does want, you know, he wants sun or ice. What token would he like? Oh, why not? Get bot for free. Leave that so he could flip it in the future, maybe? You know, there's always the thing. He wants to take that away so I can't use it, but kind of wants it there so maybe he can use it later. So it becomes blue as he takes it. Yep. Replaced it with a machine port, and he gets the sun research token. No bonus there. Ooh. Could only do 1 thing, but he kind of got away with doing 2. Does the weather machine run? No. So, bots come out. We can just take our bots back. We don't have any in there. The leftmost rain token gets discarded. The assistant moves along. Next is wind, which will happen if somebody puts a bot there. So Professor has made some progress. So I kind of want to go to the Professor just because I've got no tokens again, but I can't. I've got... How have I ended up with no... chemicals. I should have bought a chemical. I didn't want to spend my very last thing, did I? We can do a breakthrough. I've made a mistake. I don't think I can do both things, can I? I'd get a government. I've got 2 tokens, so it's one or the other. And let's just show you the breakthrough. I don't want to go there then. See, blocking here stops Marty coming here and doing both, but coming here means if he does come, he doesn't get extra vouchers. I'm going to come here. So let's do this one. So I got my government voucher. You have to have published a paper. I have. So you go there, you go there. Oh, do I want to do investment first? Oh, there we go. Investment could get me some stuff, couldn't it? Could have got me the machine part I needed. I didn't need a robot to do that. Let's investment marker. Let's have my science income. So flip this over. I still get the points if I do this at the end of the game. But now I get 1 science voucher and do one of the other tracks as if I was 2 spaces further forward. Oh, it's so tempting to wait. Oh, I'm waiting. I'm doing a take back. Yep. Don't get that science. I'm going to just put out... See, have 5 bots there isn't going to happen. Have 5 things in this column might happen, but probably not. Most subsidy tokens probably going to be Marty. 5 things in this column might happen. Take anything, I'll take science. And then next time, if I was 1 further forward in there, then I would get to move up a funding track as well. I would get 3 things from getting this funding. I've got no investment markers now, though. I'll get them. Right, yes. Have you published a paper? Yes. Okay, then. Get your breakthrough marker and pop it on one of these. It has to be the same type of weather, of course. Oh, yeah, because I'm paying 2 R&D because I need the science to be able to do this. So, yes, pop it on one of these. Pay the science cost. So So again, back to not many tokens. Do I want a machine part or 2 points? Well, I haven't paid the machine parts yet. It's a bit weird because, I'm full up of machine parts. So I don't want to gain a machine part. I might as well gain 2 points. Then you need to provide the necessary machine parts. If there is a bot there, they will provide the machine part. So what I can do is here, pay a green and a white. I get 2 points for everything I provided. My bots provide a machine part. So I would get 2, 4, 6 points. I'm using Marty's bot to provide one though, so he would get 2 points. I can do that, or I do have the other white. I could provide that myself and get an extra 2 points. Marty gets nothing, but then I've spent another machine part that I could use to do this on something else in the future, or go in the government branch or something. I'll go the cheapskate route. I'll pay my 2 machine parts, so I get 6 points, Marty gets 2 points for doing nothing. If that was full up, the tile would come off, but it's not. Had my points, and I get an award token that I can put down somewhere later on, and I'm 1/3 of the way to earning a Nobel Prize. It's as easy as that. Marty wants to come here. Oh, this kind of blocks me off as well. Marty wants to come here, so he gets an R&D voucher, which is a waste. He'd get 2 R&D vouchers. I would want this so much. He gets 2 R&D vouchers that he can't take, and also gets a science because the professor is there. Then professor moves on, takes away a research token from the space where his assistant is. Oh, almost forgot. Marty's going to get a robot. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he can take something from here now. He was going to put a robot out here. Oh, I take back. I haven't had his chemical back. Maybe wondering why that suddenly changed. I took something back because I realized he could do a combo. He can take this robot out, which lets him do the bot action for free. Pop that out without spending a blue chemical. He's in the experiment that will now happen. Then for his action, he can choose this option, paying... I've already paid one for him before the take back. Paying 2 actions. Does he have a full row? Well, no, but he can cite fog. So he can take a citation token to fill up the gap that he's got in his fog research. Slide this along, get any 2 points. Oh, wow. He's going to go government, I think. Yeah, government. And he could split it up. That's what he's going to do. He's going to go there. Points, 2, 4. Nothing for the citation. 1, 2, 3, 4. And get an investment marker. Then, does the experiment happen? Yes, Marty has made it so. Can he pay a science? Yes. He gets 2 points. And does he want to put a bot out again? So what's going to happen next? Sun, because it's coming in. It's unlikely. If the professor moves, a bot will get put here, but fog isn't anytime soon. No, he doesn't want to put a bot out. He'll take another investment marker. So he's had his points, he's had his investment marker. He gets the wind token now. He's just doing all this stuff. If he just gets a bot out there, which he could probably do from going over to government next time. Oh, wow. Yeah. So, done all that. Experiment's happened. You need to go back. You need to go away. You need to come in. And that is the round. Oh, the weather needs to get worse for wind. And that is now it. Professor isn't quite in his office yet, but if somebody comes here, he will be, which maybe Marty wants to do. He doesn't have, he needs white and green though in his machine parts, and he hasn't got them. He could get one of them and then spend some vouchers to do the other. Maybe he'll do that, but it's my turn now. Let's focus on me a little bit. I am facing a voucher crisis. I don't have any investment tiles. I can't go where the professor is because I was already there. I can come down here and get anything, but then I can't really spend much. I'm going to come over to government. Yeah, I don't want Marty to be able to do both things. You can see he's got loads of his vouchers, although I will earn him more vouchers if he comes to the left of me. So, yeah, I can only do the cheap option. I am really hurting for this stuff. I could put this down here and get 2 supply. But no, let's move up the funding track. And then put a bot out. I've got loads of bots. Oh, I think this will be okay. Let's come here. So I've only got a white machine part, so it's got to be here or here. I'm going to pay my white machine part. Oh, taking a bot is tempting, but no. I'm going to go for this. Publish a paper without an action, because that gets me... Yep, done that. Gets me the Sun Research Token. I can then put my award here, and I could publish that. Oh, I haven't taken my lab single voucher. I can't do that next time because it's two vouchers to go and do that. Yeah, I should probably have used the investment market to get funding. But I can get an investment market for publishing a paper if I manage to do that at some point. Marty has got investment markers for days. He is going to use this. Is he going to use it for income? What action is he going to take? Can he... He can't do both things anyway because the professor's there. But then we would get a load of income if the professor moves. But that kind of helps me. He doesn't really want to help me. Now, let's have him do a breakthrough. Let's do it. He's going to have the most awards. He wants a machine part. So he's going to grab green. Then he's coming over here. He gets a government voucher. Two government vouchers, but he can't fit those in. And a science, and then can do one or the other. So he could just put another bot out, actually. And then he can just publish forever. Oh, the professor moves to his office. Now, this one's more expensive, and he wants to spend more vouchers. He's going to spend one of each, because he's about to get some income. And he's going to have to spend two vouchers. Let's do one, two, to swap around a machine part. He'll swap this red to a white. He's published a paper on fog. He can do the fog experiment just like I did. He's spending just a white and green like I did, which gives me 2 points and him 6 points, so the opposite of what happened before. He puts his breakthrough marker out on here and gets a machine part. He'll get that red bag that he had before. Why not? Fog's coming up, but no, we don't really know what we're going to need. It's not going to be red, though. Green's potential for both of these that Marty's nearly finished. Yeah, he'll go for green. So he's had his points, gets an award token, which, yeah, he doesn't even need to come back here. He can just go and publish next time. Brilliant. Gets his award. This weather has now been fixed, so the tile comes back off. Oh, we needed to pay a science to be able to do that. Yeah, done that now. Those breakthrough tokens go away. Yep, yep, yep. Does the weather machine run? No. Is there a wind tile there? Yes, so it gets discarded. And the assistant moves on. There are not many experiments left. One will get discarded this turn, and next turn, and the turn after. There are not many rounds left. Oh dear, there are like three rounds left to get what we want done. And I am utterly gutted by that. Marty, I don't know why I'm saying Marty, turn order. Income, at least, here we go. I've kind of, yeah, I don't know that that would be the best move for Marty. I did it so that one of us wouldn't be completely stuck. I'm going to get a salmon gear. That's all of the income. Marty, income's only from these top ones, by the way. He doesn't get to do a free bot. He gets you and you and you. He's probably going government on his next turn. And yep, yep, yep. Professor now goes back to supply. And it is my turn. So I'm not staying here. Shall I publish the paper? Experiment's not going to happen, is it? Have three complete rows. How am I supposed to make that happen? I don't have a cylinder still. I could come here now, and I would get a couple of things. I'm just aware that like I've got like three rounds left, and I don't feel like I've got anything done. I think we wasted too much time. Marty got me carried away with doing experiments that didn't need doing. So I want to publish papers first. Publish a paper. I want to publish the most papers. Yeah, Marty hasn't published any yet, has he still? So he hasn't unlocked any citations. I'm going to have to use my award then. So done that, slide this along, move me two up a funding track. I'm going to move two up here. Then points is 248. The award's worth four. And then get myself an investment marker, which I'll 100,000,000% use for income next turn. Can't do it now though. My turn. I don't have cylinders to come here. I don't have gears to do the breakthrough, and we haven't been putting bots there. I think I need to come down to supply. Oh, the professor moved and should have put a bot out, I think. So the professor now, I get something of my choice and a science. Let's just take two. Professor moves on. At least that's, Marty was probably going to do the both of the things, so that's probably okay for me. What do I need? I need a cylinder. You're saying like green? Like trying to do this weather's going to be impossible. I need like, I've only really got ice now. So I need to put stuff in the ice column. Maybe red or blue. Red. I could get a bot, just have them available. Yeah, and that gets me a government voucher. Yeah, that's something. My sad turn. Marty is He can publish a paper now. Not going to do his investment marker yet. He is going to come over here, experiment. It's not going to happen without my help, is it? That one maybe next time. But it's the wrong chemical. Oh, yeah, he doesn't have salmon either. No, he'll just do this. So two research to publish a paper on... Oh, he gets an R&D voucher for coming here. What's the paper going to be on? It's going to be on wind. There we go. Publish it on wind, and he gets a robot for that. He's got 9 things in here now, so he could take something from this section of robots. Hold the phone. Any... last time I said hold the phone is... Marty can take this robot and a white cylinder, and then he could do the other action and do an experiment next time. Just for the fun of it. Okay. Yes. That's what he's doing. Chandler saying something sarcastic in Friends is the last time I would have heard hold the phone. I can't remember the next bit that he says, though. Much to my friend's fan shame. He'll spend a science then to do the other part, move up this funding track, put a robot out with a white chemical, and then next time, yeah, that experiment will happen, and he'll probably get some benefit from it. Why not do it if you can? End of round. Does the experiment happen? No. You go back. You go away. You come in. Then, Professor nothing. Now, me. The downsides of my voucher situation I got myself into. It's terrible, but I could come and maybe do something in government. I've got my investment tile now. Yes, first of all, investment tile. Open up all the options. Investment tile, I will take science. Probably should have done this ages ago. Yeah, that big thing where I decided not to. Should have done it. I can have 2 science. So I've got too much. What? I thought I planned this right. And then take one of the things as if I'm 3 further along. I'll do this one. 1, 2, 3. So I get... Move up a funding track again. Let's move up this one for the extra point. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it again. And then a cylinder of my choice and a voucher of my choice. Let's see. Let's have green. And... A government point? Yeah. Okay. Oh, Marty should have unlocked the wind. I don't know if he had... He probably had the science at the time to pay for the thing, but I don't know now. Did he just do it? Yeah, he just did it, didn't he? He did have the science. We can see it. So, yeah, he would have paid and got his 3 points for unlocking the citation. I'm now going to come and follow the professor. Oh, he should have gotten rid of... He moved last turn. He should have gotten rid of this. I want the ice one anyway. I do just want to flip something and have something this turn. But I get lab twice and science, which I'm full up on. Ugh. And then he comes over here and puts a bot out there. Oh, the assistant never moved, did he? I want to put a bot out here. Maybe I will have the most of these. I want R&D voucher... Oh, science voucher is wasted, though. Where's the other one of these? It's the same, isn't it? It's the same combo. So I should have paid, rather than spending government to do this, which I haven't paid yet. I'll pay science to do the... One science to do the action. And then I earn... A science and an R&D. Yeah. And I'll take this to use next time. Pop that in there. Marty is going to use an investment tile. He's going to flip this for... 2 science, and another track as if he's 2 further along. He will do this one for a machine part and 3 points. He will take a red machine part. He is going to R&D. He gets himself a government voucher, which he's full upon, unfortunately. Then, first of all, he's putting a bot out. He moves along here, then place a robot out in a space. It will be a green one. Yeah, not the one that wants him to pay a machine part. That would be bad. Then gets a workshop. He does not care in the slightest. Then, yep, and get the part for it. Oh yeah, so that's a bit wasted. But now he can get some supply vouchers. Maybe it's not. That's all done. Then, has he published a paper? Yes, on wind. Then that means he can do a breakthrough. He's going to get himself 2 points. He is going to build a prototype of green, blue, red, and his own thing. That is 8 points for himself, putting him up to 42. And he gets his second award, which he could use to do sun as well. Oh, wow. And if he could do another breakthrough before the end, he can get the Nobel Prize, which is five more points. That's his two things. Finish. Does the weather machine go off? Yes, it does. He's got a science, happily. So we're doing the fog. Here we go. He needs to pay two science to be involved in this. Gets 3 points. And does he want two machine parts or an investment token? Well, that's actually tough because I think he has got time. No, he'd have to come to government, publish a paper, and then next time he could do the machine for Sun by doing what he just did. Maybe. Got the wrong chemical, but maybe vouchers will fix that. He will take, so he'll definitely need salmon and green. Two machine parts rather than an investment token, I think. So that's done. Bot goes. He moves. That comes in, so we can see what the other experiments are. There are three of the level 3 experiments that do not come into the game. But the benefits for these level 3 ones here, loads of points as you can see, but also doing the breakthrough action for free, doing a published papers action at the very end, could be so lucrative. But we will see. There's only a few rounds left. So, for me, I might as well do this. This for free. I don't think I moved up last time. Move up. And robot out. I don't have to pay the gear. I want to come here. I can have a couple of vouchers next time. But it gets me ice. But what am I going to do with that? How am I going to get it? Like, how am I going to get the third one there? I know I wanted three complete rows, didn't I? Which is what I'm trying to go for. It's only going to be 5 points. So this is actually never going to happen. It will still be there in the final round. Yeah, this is going to get discarded this round. And they will both be there, so they won't happen. Wind will happen if it's full, and I could get a free published papers at the end. Yeah, I think this is a bad idea. I think that... I don't know why I put my bot there as well. I think I need to go in one of these rows, and the investment marker is going to be more valuable. Oh no, but then I can't do them both in the same round. We're going to have one more round after this. Because I would want a robot to move me up there one more and then trigger the investment marker, but that's not going to work. Just trying to think of how I can get the most possible machine parts. I think taking that's a good idea. That gets filled in from the bank. That completes a branch. So the government put a breakthrough marker out on that type of weather. Do I want 2 points or a machine part? Am I going to be able to do an experiment before the game finishes? I think machine part, and it will be, say, salmon. My turn, when I get in the investment marker, we're taking from doing this in a column that's got no research tokens left. And then I think I've got to come to R&D, but I would want to do that later. I get two governments, because I don't have the machine parts to do this yet. I can't use my investment marker this turn. Yeah, I went wrong at some point, and I cannot get back on track, I don't think. Oh, and I don't want salmon. I did want salmon because I wanted to make this easier, but it's this one that I would have to try and do. I'm going to put a bot in here and move me up. So it was going to move up this track because then with this I would get two machine parts and I would be able to do a breakthrough. But since I'm here now, maybe my last turn is just going to have to be to go over there. Yeah, let's move along here. Did I get my... Yeah, I had my two government vouchers. Done that. Moved along a track. And I get this. Because then at least I'll have my three things. I just think Marty's going to completely eclipse me with what he's planning to do. If he can do it, of course. He needs to build up machine parts again. But he can just... He can do what I was hoping to do, but in the right order. So that's me done. Marty. First of all, is he coming over here? He's got government vouchers to do it. He hasn't got the vouchers for here, and he wouldn't get any science because Latif needs to be to your left. And he doesn't want to block the space off of doing both things, so he's going to come here, do both government things. And he's already got the machine parts he needs, hasn't he? Yeah, so for two vouchers, flip something over. He's going to get... Oh yeah, he's going to get an R&D, which is too many, and a lab, and put a bot out here for free. He wants it in the... What does he want? Oh, he's done it here. I know he wants to publish Sun, doesn't he? He'll be able to. He'll take that. Yeah, it's all going to be fine. Put that there. without having to pay, because he's doing it as a bonus. And that gives him a machine part back. He'll take a white. Then, put a bot out. He'll do this action. Move up. Put a bot out. Spend a green, I think, so he can publish a paper next time. He's not going to have enough bots, though, is he? Yeah, he was going to do both of these things, but he doesn't need to do both now. He can just do the one. Oh, he should have moved up the funding track for doing that. Yeah, it's fine. He's saved, I think. So, you there. So I think that's it for Marty. Yep. Does the weather machine run? No, it doesn't. So that gets discarded. Has now been triggered. There is one more round. I unfortunately cannot be here. I want one more turn. Marty doesn't need another turn. Look how much more he's done than me. So investment marker or robot. And I could get funding or put another goal out. What about putting this out? Get me another subsidy. Get me a machine part that's a bit wasted. Get a blue one for ice, why not? And then come over here. I can only do one of them. Get me two of these. I could go to supply, but that seems even less point doing that. Like, I want to put a bot out here, but I don't know that it's even going to happen. Because, yeah, the going here would make Latif put a bot there. Which still, I couldn't make happen. And I'm pretty certain Marty's not going to help me put a bot out. So I think getting to do that is a fantasy. I don't have the machine parts to do this, and I was already there. So it's going to have to be, let's just get one of these. It doesn't really matter. I can't use any of the enough of the points anyway. Oh, I don't have a bot. Oh no, I just spent my last bot. So I don't gain that last research. So would it then be better to not have that out, not use the investments? So I already have a thing out there worth 5 points. I use you to get a robot, which could then get me something. Yeah, I've got 8 things out here now. What about a robot that pushes me up the government track one more time? So then I'll have the points. Yeah, and then I come here and everything works out the same way. But yeah, pay the one. Robot comes out. I just take you because I don't think I can use it. And then robot goes down there. You go there. Well, that's the wrong colour, isn't it? Pay the... I can spend 2 vouchers to swap the colour to be the right one. There we go. And that's me done. Marty can, first of all, publish a paper. He can pop his award down there. And can... Maybe I could have predicted that, actually, and put a bot out, but I didn't. Yeah, I could have taken a bot from there, maybe. And been in one final experiment. But I needed to put the bot out there to get this. So, he's doing this. He gets the reward of it, which is put a bot out. He hasn't got a bot. So, he's not doing that. He's getting his points 2, 4, 8 again. He unlocks. Oh, Sun should have already been unlocked. Maybe I had science to get 3 points. We'll never know. There's a lot going on. Then, he's going to come back over here. He's going to get a government voucher. He's going to spend his 2 R&D vouchers to do a breakthrough again with the Sun. Get 2 points. And he can provide... Oh, he's short. Oh, he's just slightly short of what he needed. He can't provide. He needed to do investment to get the... He was going to do this to get the 2 gears, and then he would have had more than enough gears. But he hadn't published the Sun paper yet. So for his last turn... Oh no, he's in a similar position. He needs one more turn that he hasn't got. Oh, and he gets another investment mark for doing that as well, doesn't he? Which he can use at the end of the game. He's won this. So what's he going to do? He can go to supply, get anything, get a supply point, spend 3 supply to move up this track for the extra point. That's what I think he's going to do. Oh no, he's not. He's going to move up this one for the extra point. And I think that's that. Oh, what a whimper of the last round. Oh, and Marty would have done that and got his Nobel Prize and everything. Oh no. Okay, but I don't think he had the science to do it either. Right, so, does the weather machine happen? No, it doesn't. Because nothing is eligible. So just before final scoring, in any order, you can place research and or reward tokens in your empty spaces to, you know, achieve your things. And you can also use your investment tiles to place or flip a goal. So I could get myself a machine port.
No.
Or get myself move up the funding track. Wouldn't get me any more points, actually. And a cylinder and a voucher aren't going to help me. So this, I've got the most subsidy tiles. I can see that. So why not pop that in there? I'm not the furthest along there. I don't have 5 bots in there. I don't have the most slots free, do I? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I do have the most. Yeah, it doesn't matter, does it? There we go. I've got the most subsidy. Why am I thinking about it? And I get a machine part for doing that. Marty, though, has 2 investment markers. He hasn't got 4 different branches of government, so ignore that. He hasn't got 6 things in this column. He hasn't got 3 machine parts left, but he can if he puts that there. 3 machine parts in his workshop, yes. And then have the 3 in the same branch of government. No, he hasn't done that. Have the most in his R&D column. He's done that and could get a cylinder for it. Well, I don't think it matters. So yeah, another 10 points in by Marty at the end. So your points equal to where your markers are on the funding tracks. So I get 5. 8, 11. Marty gets 1, 3, 8. Then, each goal tile you have met the conditions for. Have I got 5 different things in this column? No. What was I doing? 3 full rows. Yes. But so is Marty. He just got it easier. Most research. No, Marty did 3. And I only did 2. Yep. So didn't get that. Most subsidy, yes. So I get 10 points there. So at least I'm down in the same section as him. But has he got 3 machine parts in his workshop? Yes, there's 5. Has he got 5 different things in his middle column? No. Has he got the most things in his R&D column? Yes, that's 10. Has he got the most awards? Yes, I only got 1. And even if I got 2, you can be equal as well. So that's 15 points for Marty at the end. And then the Nobel Prize is worth 5 points. All of this wasted stuff is worth nothing, and that is Weather Machine. I hope you enjoyed that and it gave you some idea of what Weather Machine is like. I really hope it made sense. I'll say my biggest mistake, I don't know that it would have turned the whole game around, but my biggest mistake was that thing where I put a new goal tile instead of getting the income from here because I wanted to move up one more space, but then I didn't have any investment tiles. Should absolutely 100% have taken the income from the investment. I think it would have made me way more open to doing things, because after that point, I kind of locked myself up in vouchers and stuff, which would have been available from doing that investment action. But that is one of the tips in the rulebook, again, I think, of like, don't always think putting a new goal out is great. Getting income is fantastic a lot of the time as well. But there we go. If you would like to see more, I have done a playthrough for every Vita Lacerda game at this point, I think. Solo for all of his big deluxe numbers as well. And solo for this, when its final version comes along, I am sure. I don't have solo components. I know I got asked to do a solo playthrough for this by viewers and messagers, but we just do not have the things to do that yet. If you'd like to know what I think about Weather Machine, then that video will be linked in the description or coming up on the screen very shortly. Thank you very much for watching, though, and I'll see you for the next game. Bye, everyone.